This is Paul Catalina's Top 5 at 5:55.
Brought to you by Slapsticks Comedy Club. And not open yet, but progressing along. And so just keep on track. They've follow them on Facebook and Instagram and now on Twitter as well for updates as they go along from Slapsticks as they're bringing Little After back to Waco. I actually had a meeting with the Slapstick guys today about some stuff we're bringing to Waco that SicEm365 will also have a little Fantastic. Part in and promoting. So it's going to be some fun stuff that we're doing and bringing some good funny people in here and doing a lot of fun stuff, including Rogue Media Network as well. I'd like to give them a shout out because they're helping us out as well. But our top five, my top five surprises from the Masters. And number five, DJ misses the cut. I mean, I don't expect guys to win it two times. It's a hard golf tournament. You know, all the majors are hard. You know, Brooks kept winning the U.S. Open twice in a row. You know, it'll blow your mind because you're not supposed to do that. But winning the Masters twice in a row is hard to do. It's a hard golf tournament. I was really surprised given how he dominated the course in November, guys, that he did. He missed the cut less than 6 months later.
Different course, different type, different way that it was played compared to what was dormant, I guess you could say. Even some of the greens were a barren. But, yeah, him missing the cut was shocking. It's the first pick in our and it should have been.
Yeah. Felt great about that one. And didn't even make the cut.
So. Armstrong, your thoughts about DJ missing the cut?
Yeah, I can't say I'm completely shocked. It's a little shocking. I mean, I obviously didn't expect him to win. I didn't expect him to even be in the running. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, it literally, the course that they played this past weekend was almost not even the same course that he played in whenever it was, November or whatever
yeah.
it was.
Yeah. All right, number four, Bryson DeChambeau's roller coaster. You know, so Thursday, I mean, he looked like a dude who was not going to make the cut. I mean, he really is playing like all the other guys, like Dustin Johnson, who didn't make the cut. Then Friday, I mean, he did that what Bryson DeChambeau does and turned in a really good, solid round. You thought, okay, well, here he's making a move. And then over the weekend, yeah, he probably should have missed the cut. I mean, that's just how
he's
played.
He's explosive. Mm-hmm. He's explosive in all the directions. And he's putts better than a lot of people give him credit for. He will learn that course. He needs to play more rounds there. Heck, he could win it next year, but he's got a lot of knowledge. He needs to go spend time with Mickelson and Tiger and even with Jordan Spieth, if he would, and learn a little bit more about the hell. Sit down with Nicklaus. And Nicklaus always said, you never win a major. You let everyone else around you lose it. And that's kind of the case. Wasn't that the case when Tiger won a couple of years ago? Everyone exploded on number 11 or whatever it was on 12.
Yeah, number three, some of the young players that were making moves this week. Will Zalatoris hung on. And I mentioned this to you via text yesterday, Smokey and Armstrong. I brought it to you. It's like, so at one point, there's two holes left, and you're down by four strokes. And then because Hideki Matsuyama's not playing real aggressive golf, all of a sudden, you're only down two strokes,
yep.
And he's going to the final hole, and you've got to be sitting there in the clubhouse at Augusta where there's decorum, you know, above all, thinking like, just hit a tree. You know, miss a short putt.
You can't do that in golf. Yeah. You can't. No.
But you're human. You're like, well, what'll happen? But he was one of them. He was steady throughout. I mean, he was consistent the whole time. Victor Hovland really impressed me in that, like, he didn't let some early struggles get him down. Abraham Answer's a young guy as well who was pretty steady
even,
the whole time.
Were they even a part of it? I can't remember.
They weren't in the mix, but, like, just the way that they played early on in their Masters careers, they didn't let Augusta.
Zalatoris really impressed me. He weighs less than his golf bag.
Also, he is
string bean out there.
Did you Armstrong? Did you see the lookalike for Will Zalatoris?
I did. Yeah,
is he looks like Happy Gilmore's caddy? First caddy, all grown up. All right, and number two, the Justins, Rose and Thomas, both couldn't close. They both looked like they had opportunities to make moves. Justin Thomas, after the rain delay, really hit a wall.
Just blew up.
Yeah, just blew up. Justin Rose, I mean, it's hard to call that a collapse. He probably. And he played his worst round on Sunday.
He imploded after the rain delay.
Yeah. So, Justin Rose he had the two good early rounds and then he just probably came back down to earth, which is kind of what happens at the Masters. But neither of them could close. And you thought for a second that both these guys could maybe even win this thing.
Yeah, for sure.
So, and number one that, Hideki Matsuyama holds on. I mean, he, it's that I would think that leading that tournament is one of the most nerve-wracking things in the world.
Well, because not only are there problems always, even if you can get low and the par fives are easily reachable, most of them, it's that others can pick up three strokes on you even if you're playing well because of the 13 and 15. Do you the drive he hit on 13, did you hear the crackle of the bark and the ball hitting the tree on 13 yesterday? It was like lightning strike. I wish I could find a video of it. It's crack. I mean, it was just like that ball was going to go another 50 yards into the trees. It hit the tree, bounced out kind of towards that first cut. It was a crackle. He got screwed on 15, but so did a couple other guys. He hit the ball. The place was playing different, and he hit the ball, hit a low iron way over the green. I've never seen it catapult over the green like that on 15 into the water. But he did just enough. He scrambled well. He really scrambled well. Brandel Chamblee was mentioned in that on the Golf Channel. I mean, he got himself out of jail. Even on number one, missed a putt for par, almost made par. He finds a way to get around. You have to do that.
Yeah. No, but super happy for Hideki Matsuyama. Yeah. Seems like a really, really, really calm, cool guy. And look, you have to be. And maybe that might be Bryson DeChambeau's next step for him to win the Masters. To win that one, you really have to get out of your own head a little bit and kind of play outside your body. Tiger, the reason Tiger's won it so much is because he's really good at that. Or just didn't care about anything else going on, just knew. But DeChambeau, probably lets his, the problems get to him a little bit too much. Mad about the greens. He's probably, spend some time dealing with that. But, and Rob Bolton nailed it. He said, I don't know, these greens might eat DeChambeau up. And they did.
They did. They absolutely did. You got to have, you can blow it into the trees or into this pine straw, whatever, but you have to have a way of being able to have the angles into the greens or you're just wasting your time. And he'll learn. We'll see what happens. Mickelson, I thought, was pretty cool. Got himself, made the cut, got to 3-under at one point, but finished at even par.
Does Tiger play in another Masters?
No.
I don't know. No, but it's like.
Because they're really good. But I don't even know if, we don't know even what his capabilities are of, like, mobility. I hope to God that he's going to be okay with just that.
Yeah.
But no, that's a great question.
I threw out that question because that's a reality. And, Matsuyama needs to take the headlines for right now, but I was curious about that.
I never thought Tiger would ever win another major, maybe once, but I never thought he would. And then what did he do 2 years ago? After all of the things he had been through personally and also physically, his back, his legs, his knee and all that, he found a way. So I would never say never with him, but we don't know really what the health prognostication is. Just a great question, though. I hope he does.
If there's a guy who through sheer force of will can, overcome the leg injuries that he has, it's Tiger Woods.
Two years ago this week, he did it. Right? I don't know. I know some people don't know if he's going to do that or not. I'd like to look at DeChambeau's how many fairways he hit or how many greens in regulation he hit. Hideki Matsuyama, though, great stuff, Paul. 5 for 555. Again, you have.